From New York City, the National Broadcasting Company invites you to hear another concert by the NBC Symphony Orchestra under its eminent conductor, Arturo Toscanini. For today's concert, Maestro Toscanini will conduct the Symphony No. 9 in D minor of Beethoven. Appearing with Maestro Toscanini and the NBC Symphony today are members of the Collegiate Chorale under the direction of Robert Shaw, and as soloists, Ann McKnight, soprano, who made her professional debut with Maestro Toscanini in 1946, Jane Hobson, contralto, and winner of the 1947 Naumburg Award, Irwin Dillon, tenor, and Norman Scott, bass, of the New York City Center Opera Company. Today's concert marks the completion of Maestro Toscanini's 10th full season with the NBC Symphony, an orchestra founded especially for him with its membership drawn from among the finest musicians in the world. It was a memorable occasion that Christmas night in 1937 when Maestro Toscanini joined the orchestra here in Studio 8H to bring to listeners Vivaldi's Concerto Grosso in D minor, Mozart's G minor symphony, and the First Symphony of Brahms. That was the first broadcast. The concert about to begin is the 169th broadcast concert by Maestro Toscanini with the NBC Symphony Orchestra. At the end of the first season, the commentator spoke these words: "Mr. Toscanini's broadcasts with the NBC Symphony Orchestra have given pleasure to countless radio listeners in America and throughout the world. Radio and the National Broadcasting Company have made it possible for you to hear and to feel Toscanini's great art. Yet I wish it were possible for the maestro's unseen audience to have a glimpse of him as he walks with youthful steps onto the stage of this studio. That wish has now come true for thousands of people, for the television cameras in our studio today make it possible for the unseen audience to see as well as to hear." Beethoven's Ninth Symphony in D minor was completed in 1824. Yet its preparation had occupied the composer for 3 decades while he searched for a proper use for Schiller's Hymn to Joy, which forms the symphony's choral finale. For it was in 1793, when he was just leaving his hometown for study in Vienna, that one of his townsmen wrote to Schiller's widow, "There's a young man of this place who intends to compose Schiller's Freude verse by verse." Beethoven experimented with the idea many times, but although he contemplated a D minor symphony as early as 1812, he first intended an instrumental finale, and the idea of using the hymn did not occur to him until 1822. In that year, the Philharmonic Society of London offered him £50 for a symphony to be delivered the following spring. Beethoven accepted and sent them the manuscript, but not until a year after the symphony had had its first performance in Vienna in May of 1824. This was the performance after which the composer, by this time totally deaf, had to be turned to face the audience so that he might see the wild acclaim which he could not hear. The symphony searches, as has been said, for a resting place for the mind as a solution for human doubts and difficulties, and finds it in the Hymn to Joy. In the first movement, Allegro, we hear a great and tragic struggle, a conflict of the soul, to quote Wagner, striving after joy against the weight of the power which places itself between us and happiness. The second movement, the Scherzo, he called expressive of the theme of worldly joy. The third, Adagio, wrote Wagner, is the defiance of the soul, resolved into tender and melancholy feelings. The fourth, the chorale movement, opens with a solemn recitative for cellos and basses, rejecting one at a time the subjects of the first 3 movements. Then there is a plea in Beethoven's words, "O brothers, not these sounds. Let us raise a song of sympathy, of gladness." The exultant hymn follows, finding the answers to all questions in the theme of human brotherhood. And it is indeed fitting that Beethoven, the believer in liberty for all men, Beethoven, who had once renounced his idol Bonaparte when he discovered that his hero was not a liberator but a conqueror, it is fitting that Beethoven should have climaxed his creative life with the symphony shouting to the stars that under the fatherhood of God, all mankind are brothers plighted. Now our studio audience is awaiting the appearance on our podium of Arturo Toscanini. Here is Maestro Toscanini now. The familiar, energetic figure. His entrance a signal for a burst of instantaneous applause from our audience. And now, Arturo Toscanini with Anne McKnight, soprano, Jane Hobson, contralto, Irwin Dillon, tenor, Norman Scott, basso, and the members of the Collegiate Chorale under the direction of Robert Shaw conduct the NBC Symphony Orchestra in Beethoven's Symphony No. 9 in D minor.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Exultant closing chords of the Hymn to Joy of the Ninth Symphony of Beethoven, And our audience, as you can hear, and some of you see, has sprung into instant and enthusiastic applause. Arturo Toscanini, who had retired from the stage, entered with the young choral director of the collegiate chorale, Robert Shaw, whose choral group they heard supplementing the men of the NBC Symphony Orchestra. Here is Maestro Toscanini again with Robert Shaw and our soloist. Toscanini and the soloist have left the stage, but our audience here in Studio 8H of Radio City refuses to leave. Many of the guests have risen in their seats, and now almost the entire auditorium floor is thronged with standing and applauding members of our studio audience here. Maestro Toscanini again, and our soloist. Come to the end of our concert. Arturo Toscanini and the NBC Symphony Orchestra have performed the Symphony No. 9 in D minor, the Chorale Symphony by Ludwig van Beethoven. Members of the Collegiate Chorale, under the direction of Robert Shaw, appeared with the NBC Symphony, and our soloists were Ann McKnight, soprano, Jane Hobson, contralto, Irwin Dillon, tenor, and Norman Scott, bass. Today's concert, marking the completion of Arturo Toscanini's 10th full season as conductor of the NBC Symphony, is the last in this winter series of NBC Symphony concerts. Later this month, on April 26th, Maestro Toscanini and the NBC Symphony will appear at Carnegie Hall in a concert of Verdi's Requiem and Te Deum for the benefit of the New York Infirmary for Women and Children. Maestro Toscanini will return to the orchestra next fall at the opening of the 1948-49 season. Beginning next week at the regular time, the National Broadcasting Company will present the first of a series of spring and summer NBC Symphony concerts. Our guest conductor next week and for 3 weeks thereafter will be Eric Leinsdorf, who will conduct Bach's symphonies to church cantatas numbers 174, 18, and 29, Aaron Copland's Appalachian Spring, and Tchaikovsky's Theme and Variations from his Suite No. 3. We cordially invite you to be with us then over your favorite NBC station. Today's program was heard in Canada over the facilities of the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation and was produced by Don Gillis. Ben Grauer speaking. This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.